Her story shocked America and inspired an outpouring of national sympathy. Bethany Storrow, an attractive divorcee who had just moved to Portland, claimed a stranger walked up to her on the street and threw a cup of acid at her face. But as the police checked into her story, they say she admitted another bombshell. Storrow had splashed the acid on her own face. And last night, her stricken parents had this to say.
She's obviously dealing with some deep internal, emotional, and psychological problems that we had no knowledge of, and we hope that she'll get the help that she needs.
Join us now to explain why someone would possibly do this. Psychologist for webgirl.com, Dr. Jeffrey Gardier. Jeff, good to see you this morning.
Great to see you, Chris.
I guess this is the question that is on everyone's mind right now. What would compel someone to do something like this to themselves?
Well, obviously very deep emotional issues, a cry for help, wanting to get the attention of others. And I think some people might say this is a situation that is akin to something called Munchausen syndrome, where people fake illnesses or even injure themselves in order to get medical attention, in order to get sympathy from others, especially from medical staffs.
You know, you say this does has a, it does exhibit some traits of Munchausen, but then again, it does not at the same time, correct?
Well, we know that a lot of people who do have Munchausens, they create the illness, and quite often they may not injure themselves, but we're seeing more and more cases where they're actually causing a physical injury that will result in their getting surgeries and so on.
You talk about doing this as maybe a cry for help or a cry for attention, but the extent of this act, throwing acid on a face like this, does that say something more to what we're dealing with here, just the magnitude of what she did to herself?
Absolutely, because most folks who do have Munchausens, they don't injure themselves so severely on the outside that they could destroy their lives. So as the parents have said here, that she has very deep emotional issues, maybe we're looking at some depression, something going on, maybe some sort of abuse as a child, or perhaps she didn't get the attention she needed as a child. Maybe her hearing disability plays into exacerbating whatever emotional issues she has as far as communicating to the world in a much more appropriate manner as to what her needs may be.
Are there any signs, though, that someone is on the brink of this type of behavior?
Yeah, there are signs. And I think perhaps her parents may be in denial about that. Perhaps getting a lot of medical attention or constantly complaining of having some sort of medical symptoms or even being very depressed or anxious or having some sort of obsessive compulsive disorder. Yeah. Where there is smoke, there is fire. This just doesn't happen out of the blue.
Is this the type of person, for some reason, the severity of throwing acid on one's face, is this the type of person that's probably going to need to be on almost like a 24-hour watch for the foreseeable future?
That is a great question, because we see people who do certain things like this, not to this extent, but who have been treated for Munchausen's, they have a higher probability of drug abuse and of suicidal ideation. So obviously, wanting to hurt oneself in that way to such an extent tells me that this is almost a suicidal act in its own way, and she should be watched and is probably being on some sort of observation at the hospital.
Your professional opinion, what now happens? In facial injuries clearing up aside, now what happens? What type of counseling, what type of therapy? I mean, what does she need?
Well, she'll be evaluated to see whether psychiatric medications can help her. If there is a deeper emotional problem, such as an anxiety or depression or OCD, so they'll be looking at all of that. Obviously, a lifetime of psychotherapy, and just as importantly, she will have to have family therapy with her parents so that they can support her emotionally through these issues so she doesn't do something like this again.
Yeah, if the parents didn't have any idea that there was something going on to lead up to this, I think now...
As with many families, they're in denial about these sorts of things, but let's give them credit that they're addressing it now.
Yeah, Dr. Jeffrey Gardier, thanks so much. Good to see you.
It's always a pleasure.